of World War II that abstract expressionist painters felt that their painting had to be very serious and to emote qualities of beauty or vigor or turmoil. And in doing so, they used a lot of black, a lot of dark. It was, in a sense, a dark moment, one in which processing the horrors of the war was very much on everybody's mind. And if you think of Franz Kline, it's entirely in black and white and very fraught. Pollock, it's again, a very monochrome and heavy use of black. He also understands how to contrast color. And in fact, he uses beautiful touches of reds. And most remarkably, in the 1959 painting, he uses silver, which is possibly unprecedented use of silver that early on. And he's using it, I think, to convey an idea of light. So light and dark are very important. Edward Dugmore, like many abstract expressionist painters, came into prominence in the 1950s. His schooling was in the 1940s. He studied with Thomas Hart Benton in Kansas City. And if you think of Thomas Hart Benton paintings, you think of an extraordinarily romantic vision of American landscape. Keep that image in mind as you then project to Dugmore's abstraction, which is equally as romantic. He is very closely aligned with Clifford Still in everyone's mind, and for good reason. This was a relationship that was become a lifelong relationship and very, very important. You have an extraordinary teacher in Still, and you have an extraordinary student in Dugmore, and not all student-teacher relationships have that kind of lasting quality, but this one certainly did. And if one thinks of Clifford Still's forms, there is certainly energy and tension, but they tend to be a little bit more vertically oriented. Whereas Dugmore, who traveled through the United States back and forth many times, spending time in Mexico also, but the Rockies, where he was in Aspen for 2 years in 1960, the sense of this horizon line in Dugmore is very important and differentiates him from Still in that sense. These are his references, but I think what comes through is the essence of the beauty in the gesture, the touch. He's a beautiful, beautiful painter, just loving paint itself and how to apply it. There is a spirituality, I think we could say, to the work, which is what he was taking away from his love of nature. Dugmore is often associated with San Francisco because, of course, of the famous years that he was studying with Clifford Still in San Francisco. In fact, he was very much a part of the New York art scene, and he showed the famous Stable Gallery in the 50s, had 3 one-man shows there, and continued to show in New York on a very regular basis, and was very much a part of the Abstract Expressionist Club. He was drinking at the Cedar Tavern with de Kooning and Kline and Pollock, and was very much a part of that conversation. He's what we might call a painter's painter, meaning that the painters who know him, loved him, and respect the work enormously. What's interesting at this juncture is that there are so few great abstract expressionist paintings left on the market that are in any way reasonable in terms of price, that now collectors are looking more and more towards those other wonderful painters like Dugmore, who didn't necessarily get to the heights of their more famous peers.